If you ask any Christian, what does the Bible, your Bible say about Muhammad, they will tell you nothing. You may ask, why nothing? Does not the Holy Bible speak about the rise of Israel, the rise of communism, and even the beast? In the book of Revelation, the last book of the Bible, it speaks about a beast, and it even speaks about Gog and Magog, Yajuj, Majuj. All these things are mentioned in the Bible. They will say yes, they are. Then surely it must have something to say about this mighty messenger of God, Muhammad, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who made it possible for 1 billion Muslims today, 1 billion, 1,000 million Muslims in the world, to believe in Jesus. Because no Muslim is a Muslim if he does not believe in Jesus. This man, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who made that possible, surely there must be something about him in the Bible. The man will tell you, he says, son, my son, if there was anything, I would have known it. I would have seen it. I would have recognized it. But this word Muhammad is not to be found anywhere in the Bible. You may, if you have my book, it is being given out, what the Bible says about Muhammad. There is a reference there that in the Hebrew Bible, in the original Hebrew language, in the Song of Solomon, chapter 16, verse 5, it says, Hikko mamittakim vi kullo muhammadim zahdudi vi zahre'i baina Jerusalem. The word there is muhammadim, which is Muhammad, with respect and honor. In the Hebrew language, there are two types of plurals, plural of respect and plural of numbers. This is a plural of respect. As we read the Quran, as Allah says, Inna nahnu nazzalna dhikra wa inna lahu lahafizun. That it is for us to send down the revelation and it is for us to protect it. Who is this us? Father, Son and Holy Ghost? No, we don't believe in that. Who? Allah, Jibreel and Muhammad? Astaghfirullah. No. Who is this we? Who is this us? We know that in the Arabic language, this is a plural of respect. Allah is talking about himself like the royal we, the royal plural. So Muhammadim, Muhammad is mentioned by name. But the Christian world, in the translations, they have translated the word Muhammadim into the word altogether lovely. So when you read the English Bible, it says altogether lovely. You can't imagine that they're talking about Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Like for example, if it was the praised one, Muhammad means the praised one. If it was written the praised one, you won't think, you can't imagine this talking about Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So we said, now let us reason, let us reason. There are chapters and verses in the Holy Bible where our Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam is referred to. And we may draw the attention of the Christian world to the book of Deuteronomy. In the Old Testament, in the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 18, verses 18 and 19. I took the trouble before coming to this country, before leaving South Africa, to learn these verses in your language, in your sweet language. And in case I happen to mutilate your language, to murder your language, I know you good people, you will be kind enough to overlook my shortcomings. I assure you that whatever I say, the way I pronounce, it is not intentionally wanting to mutilate your language. In the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 18, verse 18, in the Malay Bible, it says Ulangan. 18, verse 18 and 19. Se orang nabi akan kubangkitkan. I will raise them up a prophet. Se orang nabi akan kubangkitkan. Bagi mereka dari antara saudara mereka, from among the brethren, seperti engkau ini, like unto thee, like you, like who?
like Hazrat Musa alayhi salam.
Seperti engkau ini, aku akan menaruh farmanku dalam mulutnya, and I will put my words in his mouth. Who's talking? God Almighty is talking to Hazrat Musa alayhi salam, telling him that Allah Bari Ta'ala will raise up for them, for the Jews, a prophet from among the brethren, from the Bani Ismail, the children of Ismail, because the Israelites and the Ishmaelites, the Arabs, are brothers coming from Father Abraham. Hazrat Ibrahim alayhi salam had two wives, Sarah and Hajra. The children of Sarah are the Jews, and the children of Hajra are the Arabs. And as such, they are brothers. Saudara mereka, from among the brethren. Dan ia akan mengatakan kepada mereka segala yang kuperintahkan kepadanya. And he shall speak unto them all that I shall command him. Orang yang tidak mendengarkan segala firmanku, orang yang tidak mendengarkan, hearken, listen to, and whosoever will not hearken, listen to, mendengarkan, hearken, listen to, hear, hearken segala firmanku, all that I tell him, yang akan diucapkan Nabi itu demi namaku, which he shall speak in my name. In Arabic, bi ismi. In Malayian, demi namaku, in my name. Daripadanya akan kutuntut pertanggung jawaban. To me sounds most musical. Daripadanya akan kutuntut pertanggung jawaban. So I will make him, if you don't listen to this man, this messenger of God, when he's going to come speaking in my name, I will fix you up. In the Roman Catholic version of the Bible, it says, I will take revenge. Revenge. Allah is prepared to take revenge on anybody who's not, will not listen to that prophet who comes along and speaking in Allah's name, bi ismi. Now the most important part of this prophecy, we will deal with every phrase, inshallah. Every phrase will expound that this fits our Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam like a glove. If the glove is specially made for you or for him, it fits him like a glove. The most important phrase is seperti engkau ini, seperti engkau ini. I hope you understand my Malay. You understand my Malay? Seperti engkau ini, like unto thee, like you, like Moses. So, we want to know, how is Jesus as a candidate for Christianity and Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, how do they fare in being like Moses? So we are going to do this little bit of dialogue as if His Holiness the Pope was with us here tonight. Your Holiness, you see, Jesus Christ is not a candidate for this prophecy, because in the first place, Moses and Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, may Allah bless them both, bless them all, they had a father and a mother. Moses and Muhammad, they both had fathers and mothers. But Jesus only had a mother. He had no human father. Is that true? And any Christian will admit that that is true. Moses and Muhammad both had fathers and mothers. Jesus had only a mother. So we can say, Awleh karana itu Nabi Isa tidak seperti Nabi Musa, tetapi Nabi Muhammad adalah seperti Nabi Musa. Therefore, Jesus is not like Moses, but Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is like Moses. Number two, Moses and Muhammad were both born in the normal course of things, a man and a woman coming together, like any one of us. But Jesus Christ was created by a special miracle. The Holy Bible records that before they came together, Mary and Joseph the carpenter, she was found with child by the Holy Ghost. And in the Gospel of St. Luke, when this good news was given to Maryam alayhi salam,
about the birth of her holy son, she says, how can this thing be when I know not a man? Meaning sexually, I have no experience of a male. How can I have a son? So the angel is made to say that the Holy Ghost will come upon thee and the power of the Most High will overshadow thee. In the Holy Quran we are told, when the same situation arises, that Jibril, the angel of God, comes to Maryam alayhi salam and gives her the good news about the birth of a holy son. She says, قَالَتْ رَبِّ أَنَّا يَكُونُ لِي وَلَدٌ وَلَمْ يَمْسَسْنِي بَشَرٌ. She said, oh my Lord, how can I have a son when no man has touched me? Meaning physically, sexually. What does the angel say to that? Says, قَالَ كَذَلِكِ اللَّهُ يَخْلُقُ مَا يَشَاءُ. See, even so, Allah creates what He wills. وَإِذَا قَدَى أَمْرًا فَإِنَّمَا يَكُولُ لَهُ كُنْ فَيَكُونَ. Say, whenever He decrees a matter, Allah decrees anything, He just says, كُنْ بِي and فَيَكُونَ, it happens. This is the Muslim concept of the birth of Jesus, that without any male intervention, Hazrat Isa alayhi salam was born. Moses and Muhammad, both born in the normal course of things. Jesus, born by a special miracle. Ask the Christian, is it true? And without hesitation, the Christian, any Christian worth the name, will admit that it is true. So you can say, Awli karana itu Nabi Isa tidak safarti Nabi Musa tatafi Nabi Muhammad adala safarti Nabi Musa. Therefore, Jesus is not like Moses, but Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is like Moses. Number three, Moses and Muhammad both married and they begat children. A normal human life. Both. They both married and begat children. But Jesus remained a bachelor all his life. Is it true? Ask the Pope. Then he will tell you yes. Or any Christian will say yes. Therefore, we say, Awleh karana itu Nabi Isa tidak safarti Nabi Musa tatafi Nabi Muhammad adala safarti Nabi Musa. May the peace and blessings of Allah be upon them all. Therefore, we say Jesus is not like Moses, but Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is like Moses. Number four, Jesus, Moses and Muhammad, they both had a rough time. The people, they didn't accept them wholeheartedly without a struggle. To Hazrat Musa alayhi salam, his people gave them endless trouble in the desert for 40 years. Our Nabi Karim sallallahu alayhi salam, you know, for 13 years he suffered in Makkah. He had to make the hijrah to Medina. And even in Medina, they didn't leave him alone. You remember Badr and Uhad and Khandaq. No peace, no peace. But before Hazrat Musa alayhi salam died, or Hazrat Isa, Hazrat of Nabi Karim sallallahu alayhi salam, he died, both the people, they accepted the prophets as the messengers of God. They gave them trouble, but before they died, they were accepted as prophets by their people in their lifetime. But Jesus Christ, the Bible tells us that He came unto His own, but His own received Him not. He came unto His own, mean the Jews, He came for them, but they all rejected Him. And even after 2,000 years of Christianity, 2,000 years, His people as a whole have rejected Jesus. They call Him an imposter, and as a false prophet, they say they killed Him on the cross. Whereas we say, Allah says, وَمَا قَتَلُوهُ وَمَا صَلَبُوهُ. They didn't kill Him, nor did they crucify Him. But according to you, our Christian brethren, we can ask them, is that true? That Moses and Muhammad both were accepted by the people in their lifetime, whereas Jesus was rejected in his lifetime, even now for 2,000 years. Is it true? And he has to admit it is true. We say, Awleh karana itu. I think you'll remember. By the time I'm finished, I'm sure you'll have my heart at this. Awleh karana itu Nabi Isa tidak safarti Nabi Musa tatafi Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Adala safarti Nabi Musa. Therefore, Jesus is not like Moses, but Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is like Moses. Number five. You see, Moses and Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they were both prophets as well as kings. A prophet is a person who receives inspiration, wahi, revelation from Allah, to guide their fellow brethren. That's a prophet of God, the mouthpiece of God. They speak the word of God, but they're not gods. Among them, we believe Hazrat Musa alayhi salam, Dawud alayhi salam, Sulaiman alayhi salam, Ibrahim alayhi salam, Ishaq alayhi salam, Isa alayhi salam, and on and on and on. We accept them all.